Greetings, this is Martindale with Martindale Marketing. And in this video, what I want to do is just walk you through a quick tutorial on how to use your Mac computer to create your very own timeline cover photo. It's very easy to do, and I just want to show you the quick steps to do it. First of all, I want you to notice that the Facebook timeline dimensions are 851 by 315 pixels. So keep that in mind, because what we're going to do is create the picture and then take a screenshot of it and then change the dimensions to this size right here. Also keep in mind that here on the left hand corner of your timeline cover photo is where your personal image goes, such as this right here. All right, now we're going to go into Pages, open up Pages, and open up a blank page layout document. What I like is the blank canvas landscape, because that gives me plenty of room to work with whatever I want to do. So I open that up and here we go. Now the first thing I want to do is find an image that I like. So I'm going to open the media browser. Scroll down till you find the image you like, and here's an image that a photo that I took of Mount Rainier a couple months ago, and I'm just going to use that for this example. Okay, get your photo nice and big. Keep in mind that the proportions of the photo or the timeline cover needs to be long, really wide, and not very tall. So keep that in mind when you're selecting a photo. Next, I'm going to click on text box, and then I'm going to enter my text for my main title, which I'm just going to put Martindale Marketing. Okay, and then I'm going to move that up here, drag this out nice and long, select the text, and I'm going to make that about 36 pixels big, and then I'm going to change the font to say Impact, and the color, I don't know that I want it all black like this, so I want to show you a really cool trick that you can do with your Mac computer, and that is to have your text highlighted, click on color, and click on show colors, and then come over to the color inspector, and this little magnifying glass means you can choose whatever color you want. What I would like to do is take from my picture the colors that are in this picture to create my text. So you can kind of go down through here and say, okay, I know I want it to be dark. What are some dark colors that are going to be very evident in this picture? And just select it. Now my text is the same color as this ridge of trees, which is probably going to be in my timeline picture. Next, I want to change this last word. So I'm going to do the same process, and let's just go with, you know, something lighter, a little bit lighter, and that's going to create a little bit of a contrast between Martindale and Marketing, which I like that. Now the last thing I want to do to the text is add a shadow, and you just go into your inspector for that and choose the graphic inspector, which is this little box with the circle, and then come down and check mark shadow. Now I like this 3.3.50%, 3-point offset, 3-point blur, and 50% opacity. I think that looks nice. So we're going to keep it at that. All right, I'm just going to make this text box a little smaller. That won't change the size of my text, just makes it easier to work with my text box. Okay, one more text box. I'm going to put online marketing coach. And do the same thing, only I'm not going to make the text quite as big on this one. I'm going to make it about 24. Actually, that's too big, so I'm going to go 18. Italicize, and we'll select the Georgia. Now, this text, I want to be a little bit quieter. So let's do the color selector, show colors, selector tool, and then we're going to pick something that's pretty quiet. and yet it's the same colors that are in the picture. So you just have to kind of decide where you want that text to show up and how you like it. I would like it to be just a little bigger. And my next option is 24, so I don't like that. I'm going to type in here 20. There, it's just a little bit bigger now. I'm going to make that line up here with the end of the G. And I'm starting to like that. So, once you get your text the way you want it and the picture, the background picture the way you want it, then what you do is you get rid of all your selectors by clicking outside the box. And now we're going to take a screenshot of this picture, change the size, and upload it to Facebook. How do you take a screenshot on a Mac computer? It's very, very easy. Hold down Shift, Command, and 4. And that brings up your screenshot selector. Now find out where you want to start your selection and click, or left click, and then drag until you reach where you want, and keep holding down on your mouse or your selector till you get about the proportions that you want, till it looks about like a timeline cover, and then release it. And what that does is it drops it on the desktop. I'm going to hide my pages here and go over to my new screenshot. Now I opened that up by double clicking on it, and here's my new timeline cover in, it just says screenshot.png, but I've opened it in preview. Click on tools and come down to adjust size. Now we're going to change this size to our 851 by 315, which it's a little bit too tall, as you can see. So here's what I want to do in that case. I'm at 859. So what I'm going to do is you can see now it says 852, 851. Now just drag straight down until you get to 315 and let go. Now Command K is going to be the crop tool. So Command K, now I've got it cropped. Now the other way of doing that is when we were in Pages, take a screenshot, and if it's real close to the dimensions already, then when you're in here in Preview, go down to Adjust Size and just change the dimensions right there and click OK, and it's done. Now I'm just going to change the title of this file to Timeline Cover, and then I'm done. Now go into your Facebook account, and right here on the right corner says change cover. Upload photo on the desktop, find your newly created timeline cover right there and click open. There it is. And it says drag to reposition, but since we sized it exactly right, there's no need to do that. So there's just one last step, and that is click Save Changes. All right. Now, as you can see, I have my personal profile picture here so that people know who this Martindale is. And then I have a nice little mountain in the background with the text to tell who I am and what I do. And you're done. Now, there's one more thing you can do if you want to. That's refresh your page, and you can see that this your timeline is now updated. It says Martindale has updated his cover photo. If you don't want your people to see that, just click Hide from Timeline, and it'll hide it. All right, that's all for this training video. I hope that you are enjoying the power of your Mac computer for your online marketing purposes.